of education, located in Anambra State.
Maybe go. I'm not working on man, it's just that here in the environment. If not, what can you imagine?
Can you hear me? This is the chapel inside the school compound. And it's really a befitting school where you have a lot of facilities. There are banks, two different banks, Zenith Bank and Fidelity Bank, used by the school. And by this other side is the school gallery, the art gallery. I'm going to take a close view. This is the multimedia micro teaching laboratory, constructed and funded by the federal government of Nigeria. This school is highly endowed. These are the banks. One of the banks I've been talking about, Zenith Bank, and right beside it is the Fidelity Bank. I think it's one of the best in the southeast Nigeria. These are the arts. The artworks made by some of the students really an edifice. Nwafor Orizu College of Education. We are in the art section. From here, I'll be taking you to the various departments I've got. Beside here is the business center. There are various business centers there. I'm going to bypass it. Let me just say that this school is an entire village. Yeah. It is an entire village. There's a giraffe and an ostrich. Works made by some of the students. This is the art department. The various classrooms and departments. Different blocks. Honestly, I must tell you, throughout my existence, I've never heard any case of cultism in Nwafor Orizu College of Education. It is a school where discipline is in the highest order. That's why they've got more of students and parents always advise their kids to come here, because their morale is of standard. Yeah. Morale is of standard. As I said earlier, this is the Department of Fine and Applied Arts. They've got other departments. National Information and Technology Development Agency, ICT Center. This is it. And it is a full building. I like this school. Okay. We'll continue. This is their lawn tennis court and basketball court, highly in a dilapidated form. Nwafor Orizu College of Education would have been the best in the country, but for only one reason, I cannot recommend the school. And if you ask me why, I would say it's because their facilities and structures are out of date and no longer current. So, for that reason, I can't recommend this school for any of my friends. For all of this to be back again, things back in their positions. In terms of teachings, I can tell you they are the best. This is their football pitch. One will say, is this actually a football pitch or a desert? Infrastructures are no longer. this way leads to the female hostel, but due to security reasons, I don't want to go there. Let me just direct you there. So the lecturer's quarters. This is the slave man during the time of slave trade. When Africans were still under captivity. This statue you've seen here is mounted on their, just beside their pitch. You see the man shouting, "The chain is broken and freedom has been granted." Oh, I love this. You see why I say this school is more of a village? The vast nature, I mean, it's something we can't cover in a day. It's so large. And I pray that very soon, though it's in the making, they're looking into converting it to a university, which I believe in non-distant time, Nwafor Orizu College of Education. No longer be College of Education, but Nwafor is university. And I think by then a lot of things would have changed. The infrastructures would be worked on, the road network